shit like, this shit just getting way too easy.
Ill Will made the beat bouncy, bouncy, bouncy,
bouncy. I tryna sound, I got a block.
I'm really heavy, got a block on me. I walk around with a knot on me. I try to tell them ain't no stopping me. I do it right so they can copy me. Ain't a such thing as failing if you really try. See when a nigga play with me, that's when a nigga die. I spend a band on these doshies, don't ask a nigga why. All they think is a game, cause a nigga fly. I run it up, I keep counting, I ain't stopping soon. I got this motherfucker open like a locker room. I'm playing with them band-aids and I drop it too. Them SK bullets flip, them bitches be hopping too. I'm a fly ass nigga with an attitude. I'ma bag up my dope, yeah bitch, I'm a bagger too. I'ma forever get money and I'm a savage too. I can tell how she walk, that bitch nasty too. I got a nice shot banging that bitch doing bands. You was never on my level, you a corner man. We gon' keep the yellow tops, you know I'm going brand. Come out with big ass jugs, that bitch going jam. Just admit it, I'm the business, whole never level. Oh, it get wicked with the quickness, no, never settle. I leave town and go up, I get the pound so fluff. They say my sound so tough, the whole town on us. I'm really heavy, got a block on me. I walk around with a knot on me. I try to tell them, ain't no stopping me. I do it right so they
can copy
Yeah, man. You're now tuned into me. $1 million worth of game on Wallow 267 right here. That's
Gilly the King.
It's Don't right call here. Me white girl.
But it's your boy Tony the Closer.
My man Tony the Closer. That song right there, that song of the week is by YG Tech featuring Mozzy. So we talking about
Baltimore.
You know, Baltimore and San Francisco. That's called Omi, man. Check them out, man.
This episode of
$1 million worth of game is brought to you by Barstool Sports. But our first sponsor is Roman Swipes. I think probably you and Tone can use these Roman Swipes. What they do is they wake your piece up. This area right here, it's just a swipe. You swipe it on there. You like this.
Just a
like
swipe.
I'm talking about what'd you say?
Just a swipe.
Yeah, it's a swipe. Ain't no pill, and you don't need no prescription.
Now see how you threw that out there, but you see who really needed it, huh?
Yeah, he said it's a swipe.
It's just a swipe.
Hey, just a swipe, man.
Hey, nothing to be embarrassed.
Just listen.
Though,
all you need is a swipe. One thing about it is easy to use, and it's fast acting with no prescription. So you just do like this. You just like that. So you know, a lot of dudes need some help in that area. You know what I mean? So if you're coming up short and you're not able to deliver the way you need to deliver. You might need to get with a Roman Swipe. And what you need to do is you need to go to GetRoman.com. And what you need to use is $1 million/, that's the code, GetRoman.com/million. You only get your first month for $5 with a monthly plan. But one thing about it, you swipe it, let it dry, and then it's game time.
So basically, Roman Swipes, you should one swipe and it'll get you right.
One swipe. Whip it.
Why so loud?
So you think I'm saying?
Because you want swipe. Let me tell you something. When you having a hard time getting that piece up, activating that piece,
right?
You could never understand. You could never understand because you know why? Your piece ain't going to never go out on you.
My piece good.
Right. But when you an older nigga, like, you know, Tony and Lowe, when you got a problem,
you older than both of them.
Activating that piece. My piece is still activated.
But see, at the end of the day,
so are all your pieces activated?
One swipe and it gets you right.
One thing about
you
it,
activate your own piece.
When you order it, it comes in a discreet box. So if you don't want nobody, your neighbors to know, or when they delivering the package, nobody know that your piece don't work and you just need an extra, some help. You need some help. It's just help.
Mm-hmm.
Go check out GetRoman.com/million.
One swipe and it'll get you right.
Yeah, so let's get into it, man.
Right.
First month on you, bro. First month on you. I got you.
Hey, let's get into the $1 million worth of game. Ooh. First thing I'm going to talk about, August Alsina.
August.
Now, August Alsina said that my mentor, you know, the legendary, because y'all know I go by Gil Smith. The legendary Will Smith.
Didn't know
Smith.
That. Never
Nobody
knew
that.
But you were Gilly the King.
Little bitch, you're slipping like a bad transmission.
Only knew that was ice
road. First of all, hold on. Let me just say this. Back when I was pimping, I was Gilly D fucking Williams. All right? When I'm a rapper, I'm Gilly the Kid. When I'm podcasting, I'm Gilly the King. When I'm producing fucking movies, I'm Spike G. And when I'm fucking acting, I'm Gil Smith.
And when you told on me, you was Squill Smith.
Oh.
Yeah, but that's
when
why
do the nut ass nigga part come?
You Squill Smith. It was Wallow, it wasn't me.
Damn.
Wow.
Come on, they got us. No, you told me you were Squill Smith.
Come on, they got us.
Squill Smith.
No, first of all, the only reason why you got caught is because you run like you got two fucking left feet.
Now I'm an athlete.
Yeah, you know I mean?
I'm an athlete.
We getting up out of there, skedaddling. You want to be talking about weight up?
No.
Why would I wait up and the cops is behind us? Okay, it's every right. man for himself once the annoying. Cops get on us.
One more thing. When I was skedaddling, you was tattling.
Oh.
Okay.
So you gotta remember, I used to rhyme. So don't get this fucked up. That's where you got your little spit from, your little. But back to what we saying, August. Back to August, even though it's July. But go ahead.
They said August said that he got permission to blaze Jada Pickett.
What?
Newsflash
from Will.
This how you know if that's the case that Will is his mentor because he get Tootie side nigga Sundays. He get permission too. So it's a big
that's
thing.
That's a good point.
At least a nigga got permission, bro. It's a lot of niggas that ain't even getting the permission
because you ain't getting Meek permission to blaze your bitch.
Because the Meek thing.
Meek ain't get no permission to blaze your bitch.
Hey, they ain't the only motherfucker that ain't get permission. Shit, she was throwing that pussy to everybody.
Damn. So wait, so take wait, hold tone.
Did you ever get STD?
Nah, I'm good.
Tone, let me ask you a question.
No big deal.
So you saying she was an ultra whore? She was the UW.
Hey, she had a couple. Man, she got a roster, bro. Oh, she star studded now.
I don't think that's really the case.
Free.
I just think Tone is hurt and he just adding.
Oh no, no cap.
That's why he put mustard on the bitch jacket.
Hey, listen, bro, that motherfucker got a lineup.
Don't take what Tone is saying. I just believe that he's a little hurt.
She's
he's
free just a little spirited. Hurt.
Yeah, he ain't gonna let yesterday go. But back to August, even though we in July.
So how do y'all feel about that? Like I've been with two for 20 plus years, so she gets side nigga Sundays. I let her get with a little young boy, you know, taking the Wendy's, getting a 4 for $4 in the chili bowl.
I'm gonna tell you how I feel like dog, like August. Why the fuck is you running your mouth?
Yeah, why would you put that out there?
Like that's why a lot of women don't be want to move the way they want to move because dudes be running their mouth, and a lot of people got a lot of things going on the privacy. And even if y'all was single. Now, women, this is shit women be like, damn, I don't be wanting nobody to know I got a body count or what's going on in my personal life. Or
true.
If I'm extra freaky, if I like stuff or this
true.
Thing. Like,
so is August Alsina a lame ass nigga for that?
Yeah, you don't for tell sure. him. Yeah, fuck you.
That was my issue.
Listen, even on the neighborhood aspect, you don't run around telling people, yeah, I fuck what's the name. Yeah, I fuck. Like, why would you put that? That ain't nobody's business because right. you might block a move. You got dudes out here that's move blockers. Mm. They'll block a woman move. From getting with somebody that's really trying to, that they could grow with and build with,
right.
because you telling, yeah, you know I fucked it, you know what's the name, fuck mm-hmm. you, and then dudes be running around here advertising other people dick work. Oh yeah, you know what's the name, fucked up,
right?
Like you know boo boo fucked. No, who did you fuck, dog? Why you keep talking about right. who
exactly.
fucked it, and you trying to knock your man off the course,
right.
trying to knock him off of course when they really could have built some solid foundation.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? At the end of the day,
but then sometimes you got to knock a nigga off course because if you don't, then they end up like the closer. See, if the closer would have had the nigga, they'd be like, no, Ronnie, Bobby, Ricky, and Mike, fuck the cool it now, you gotta slow it down.
That's up to the closer to check her whole facts. You
no,
know
no,
what I
no,
mean?
No,
I don't
no,
think
no,
a guy
no,
should
no, first
bring
of all,
it
first
to
of all,
her.
Let me just tell you something. First of all, when you a person that live in one city and you meet a female that live in another city, you don't know absolutely no fucking body that know this bitch. So
fact.
This bitch could tell you whatever. Just like, it's like when niggas go to college. You could have been an ultra bitch ass nigga in your whole neighborhood. But you go to college, you meeting all new people, you could tell them whatever the fuck you want to tell them. You could sell them whatever type of dream you want. You know how many niggas is on Lincoln and Cheney Universities fronting, mm-hmm. acting like they was one of those niggas.
Yeah.
And they, no, I was beating niggas up. Now you're from North Philly. Nigga, shut up. All right.
You're from Alsina.
It didn't even matter. You wasn't doing none of that. But they get the front. They get to go. They get to be whoever they want to be. They get to lie. Just like niggas in prison.
Oh, no. So
like Wallow
went to prison to lie to everybody.
Listen, so at the end of the day, you was a PD, a penitentiary director, because you directed me right to prison.
Oh,
nigga.
Dang,
he done it. Not. But that's another story.
I feel like with the whole August situation, first of all, I didn't understand why we were so surprised. I feel like every 4 to 5 years, some freaky, kinky Will Jada shit pop out. They freaky. Okay, they have open relationships, and I think it works for them. But August fucked the whole thing up for them. That was kind of corny, and you look crazy. But I would like to tell you young fellas, that's what that old lady coochie would do for you. DM Ooh. Me.
See, that was a
she fucked him up. You see him, that man said I could die today knowing that I have seen true love. There ain't nothing but an old bitch did some nasty shit to me. Never had before.
What you do?
That happened to me when I was young.
You eat a nigga ass from the back, huh?
I don't eat no ass. Now, he always got to, you always got to take it down Paul Street. You know what I mean? We on market. He got to take it right to Paul Street.
He just talking about the shit that you know,
that
be doing.
That he is, too. Ain't nothing wrong with getting your ass at home. I ain't eating no ass. I ain't get there yet. But it ain't nothing wrong with getting your ass at letting your woman give you this much finger. This much finger's okay.
But you, that's, so you eat some cake, too.
No, I know facts. It's a grand. This much finger's gay. This much finger's gay. And this much, put your finger back up. His fingers are small.
My fingers are long.
Now, TV land, I don't know, but here, the finger's this big.
You know what that means?
My finger's bigger than your hand. He's holding my hand, Dale, and his hands are softer than mine, too.
This supposed
to be softer than yours. That means y'all here like you do construction, bitch. Fuck, you're changing. Bitch, changing spares on Honda Accords.
Well, while Lola Gillian said is right, you keep the secret, hold it down, and then it's like y'all fuck it up. It's like if she wants to feel freaky and call you, she's not because you ran your fucking mouth. Stop running your mouth, dummy. To the young boy,
stop doing this. So I had to check my young boy. Stop sending screenshots. Stop sending videos or whatever, chick. Stop that corny shit, bro. Like, stop that.
Posting sex tapes.
Like, women can't. A lot of women that be willing to get busy with, once you get your name fucked about,
hey, that's
done.
Some good bragging pussy, though. To brag on some hitting Jada Pinkett is a big fucking deal. I would brag on that. If I hit Jada,
you go out there and tell her.
You just been a nut ass nigga like all
get to. Don't do that. Hey,
look, you would have been September Alsina.
To my niggas, no, I wouldn't have went, no, I wouldn't have went online.
April Alsina.
Nah, I wouldn't have went online. I'm talking about to my
this
niggas.
To your
always
niggas,
think
okay.
about April.
That's fair.
I said it because it's an A. April Alsina.
And we did establish that Lowe spent the bag too, y'all.
Yes, we did establish that he capped last week, y'all. He spent big money. I think it was like 50K for six months.
What y'all saying? He ain't caught it, he bought her.
Hey, he bought her.
You got
ain't nothing wrong with it.
He caught and bought her. I'm a player, not a payer.
Ooh, talk
one thing about me, Philadelphia Slim.
Talk
that. You got me fucked up. Newsflash. I ain't a part of these new brand dudes out here. Well, you gotta have some designer shit on, you gotta have some jewelry, you gotta have some money to pill something. Not me. Mm. They used to call me Pill Smith. Because I'll pill a chick in a heartbeat. Yeah, I never was one of them boys.
You spend that 50 bands,
because
too.
Because it would separate me from a lot of cats.
They said they used to call you Steel Smith because you used to steal a lot of shit.
Yeah, I used to do that, too, but that's another story. But the whole case is...
They said right now they call you Shield Smith because you're a fucking cop. Officer Jonathan Tackle, you bloody ass nigga.
Yeah, screw. Okay, he's telling on me again. But back to the whole August situation, Youngbloods. Stop telling people who you operate with and who you creeping with. And like, come on, man, you fucking the whole creep up. Like, you fucking anything up, because there's a lot of chicks that might be looking at you. And when you talk about them, that old coochie is different. I had some of that when I was a young blood before I went to the penitentiary.
How that old
outstanding.
Coochie.
Changed my life.
Boy.
And she gave me the game of how to operate in the sex game. I'm talking about the experience.
Yeah,
it was unbelievable.
You.
So she told you.
She said, lick to the right, lick to the left.
She said, slow down, young player. You ain't hitting that pussy.
Open
no,
your mouth. Open your mouth.
It was a wild thing. And she dropped me off when a nigga was coming home from jail. She dropped me straight off. I seen her on a Germantown Lehigh. This you know, and when I seen it, she was like, "Nigga, you better not say nothing to me."
Mm. And you knew
Playboy
you
was in
did,
the store,
right?
And he was husky, and he was fresh out of jail. I was like, "Oh man, I'm glad I didn't see that." Yeah. But she, listen, man, she was something else, man.
This nigga's crazy. Wait a minute, she denied it. Before we leave there, Jada denied everything. Just to put that out there, she says it never happened. He lied. So we don't believe you though, baby. You fucked that boy up and made him get a 27 piece. He got a Jerry curl with a patch, a blind patch in the front. Old
so
lady.
So you
coochie.
Get a young. What's the youngest you'll date?
25.
20. You
10.
Fuck.
Like 10 years younger than me. I'm like around something.
You would date a young boy 21?
Yeah, I take him.
Like, and what you going? Is you going to have the game laid out for him and anything?
I aspire to get rich and like buy a nigga a watch. Like, I want to straight take care of the nigga.
Yo, you want a young boy?
She
want
to be a sugar mom.
She want to be a sugar mom.
I aspire to be a sugar. I want to get one of you pretty
Let me
young
suck
things.
Dick from the
I
want back,
to, I want to invest in your career. I want to get your mixtape out for you. And you know I'm gonna post it. I do promo. Man, right.
She gonna post a nigga mixtape.
But you gotta listen.
She wanna be like this young man, young.
They
man.
Do it, women. Men get a young girl. Me and his age. They get a young girl, and it's totally acceptable. Bitch, be 19, fresh out of college. I'm not saying y'all do, but men your age do, and it's okay. Pretty young thing. Why I can't give me a pretty little young thing with the little lines right here, the little lines. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I still lines. Got lines. Fuck
you ain't got them fucking lines. Pull them out. I'm tired of you. Pull the fucking lines out.
She going too like you, but yeah. She going, you keep asking me to pull his dick out all on camera.
Ain't gonna ask you to pull dick. I said pull the lines out.
You keep all I'm seeing, ladies, if you camera too, gonna stop fucking with y'all. Get that bitch.
We
off
can
the
get
show.
A young nigga just like
that. So
let
me just tell y'all something. If she
bitch.
Ain't here next week, it's because she ain't asking nigga pull his lines.
Pull your piece out. Pull your piece out. Just
hey,
prove
listen,
it.
Let's get into our second sponsor, man.
Let's get into our second sponsor. Our second sponsor is Manscaped, the wood whacker. Now. It ain't the wood whacker. I'm fucking with you. The weed whacker. But listen, that's what I call my joint when I be doing my regular with the lawnmower. They call it the lawnmower. I call it the wood whacker because it clean me up. But the weed whacker, right? One thing about this is this. Dudes be moving around. You got hairs coming out your nose, hairs coming out your ears.
Yeah.
That's where the weed whacker come in. Get in there. I tried it. It's a great thing. You know what I mean? Because I was a dude that when I was in the joint, I used to use nail clippers. And I used to clip my nose hairs. But then when I came home, I was going to get it waxed, right?
How did you fit it?
But why was you getting manicured in prison?
I wasn't getting manicured.
Yes, she was.
No, it was irritating. I didn't say
why did you care about your nose hair in jail?
No, because it was irritating me. It wasn't.
It's too much grooming. It's too much grooming for prison, man.
No, hold up.
You're getting pedicures and grooming and eyebrows waxed and shit.
It's just that my hair was just, it was busting out my nose sometimes.
He was a
masseuse. Nothing to hide.
No.
Be yourself.
I wish when I was in jail, speak commissary your truth. Had the weed whacker in there, then I would have been up. But a lot of dudes be walking around and it's like they be growing trees out of their ears and growing trees out of their nose. So that's one thing about the weed whacker. You take that, and I'm talking about it to change your life. One thing is for nose, ears trimming, you know, lasts for 90 minutes. So if you got that forest in your nose or your forest in your ears, because you got a lot, you be having little hairs hanging out your joint. Like,
yeah, that's cool.
Sometimes you be having little bushes hanging out. I ain't going to touch you. I'm just saying. But you had little stuff hanging out your ears. But one thing about it, replaceable blades every 3 months. I'm saying what you got to do is get 20% off and free shipping. Use code MILLION, WW, MILLION, WW at manscaped.com.
That's what's up. Manscaped. McCore Maker. Is a top high
school. Oh, he's a legend. He just went to Howard. He's a legend.
He's a top high school basketball player.
Where's he at? For those that don't know, where he at in the top 10 out of all the basketball players in the country?
I think he's in the top 10. Out of high school basketball players, I'm pretty sure he's in the top 10.
Yep.
And he could have went to any college he chose to go to.
He went to HBCU, Howard University.
He went to Howard University.
Game changer. Game changer.
Game changer. Absolute legendary. Game changer.
How do y'all feel about that?
I love it.
I'm gonna just say, can I speak mine?
Shout out to Howard.
To be able to have the opportunity to go to any college, all the big college, UCLA, whatever college, and to say, you know what? I'm gonna be the one to sacrifice to go to HBCU to let dudes know that you could be a big athlete and it's cool to go here. So we could get like we're gonna be straight up. These colleges are making shitloads of money.
Yes, they are.
And then you got these small HBCUs, they looking for donations. I seen one years ago, they was looking for donations. It was so brave of him to be able to step out there and sacrifice because more than likely he's still going pro.
Yeah. But our
to show
sport.
But to inspire our people to say, you know what, it's cool to be a big as shit and go to HBCU, bring that attention, bring that traffic, bring that money that's gonna come
it's
there
the
that's
money.
Go to the
bring
big.
More
it's the
guys
money.
Like
it's everything.
You.
It's the money. I went to Winston-Salem State.
Okay.
Yo, to get a guy of that stature to go to from a which potentially would have been a Kentucky, Duke, yeah. Carolina type prospect. To get him to go into a black college, that changes the dynamic of who, like, all the money that, where's the money flowing now? We know all, what's the top athletes, all black. Yep. Every top prospect coming out, NBA players, all black. But
sport.
We sending all of our players to white colleges. Mm-hmm. If we start pushing our dollars, we always talk about how we protect our dollar, like, to be in a black community and then have our athletes playing for our colleges, it puts the money back where it's supposed to be.
Yes.
At because the money's going to follow the athlete, not the school.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
And that's real because at the end of the day, somebody got to sacrifice.
Right.
We always talk about we want change. Everybody quick to talk about change, but nobody trying to make the change that they say that they want.
That's
and nobody
right.
want to be step up and say, you know what, I'm gonna be Rosa, I'm gonna sit on the bus,
the sacrificial
I'm gonna do this. Nobody
lamb.
Everybody want this fucking change though.
I'm gonna just say it from this standpoint. It's good for Howard University as a college and a university, but if that was my motherfucking son, he wouldn't be going to motherfucking Howard University.
Yeah.
Where the fuck would he be going?
He'd be going if he got an opportunity to go to one of the top programs in the fucking country.
And why is that?
Because TV exposure.
He's gonna get that anyway, bro. He's gonna get that anyway, bro.
Let me tell you something. Let me just tell you something, dog. You is not getting it. You're not gonna sit here and bullshit me. Neither one of you niggas. It ain't no fucking way that a nigga going to Howard University is going to get the same TV exposure as a nigga going to Michigan State, Texas, Duke, North Carolina. North Carolina ain't been shit in years. Mm-hmm. When you turn that goddamn TV on, you see North Carolina on a Saturday afternoon on channel motherfucking 3, 6, or 10, or 29. You is not seeing Howard University on none of them stations. So what I'm saying, I let you niggas talk. Now, if you niggas want to go ahead and then I let you niggas talk again and rethink what the fuck y'all want to say, and then I'll go after you niggas again.
Spit it out, goddamn.
Because at the end of the day, I'm saying it's great for Howard University. Mm-hmm. It's great. But if that was my motherfucking son.
Right.
No.
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, you one of the best high school basketball players in the world. So the chance, and you're 6 foot 40.
Yeah.
So that's
and you something. Run, you jump, you can shoot, you're athletic, you nigga, you're going to the league.
He okay. going to
like
league
you
anyway.
Said, it's oh, sacrifice. That's you. He's saying he don't want his son to be the sacrificial lamb. That's it. No, y'all I didn't saying say the same
that.
Thing.
What I'm saying is, I understand that this shit is about changing your motherfucking family's course, providing for your family. So, no, we going to give you the best opportunity to provide for your fucking family. And then, if you want to be the sacrificial lamb or all this shit when you got money like LeBron James right now. Mm-hmm. He wasn't doing none of that dumbass shit before he got the money. No, I got to get the I got to get the money first. And then, I can rep when I got enough power and it mean enough to represent for the culture. Then I'm going to represent. When my voice is at an all-time high, then I'm going to represent. I'm not taking no motherfucking hit at 17 years old for the culture. No. Right. I got to get my fucking bag. I got to make sure because how this shit is broken down, it go in picks. Okay? So it go, if you the first pick, you get this amount of money. If you the second pick, you get less than him. If you're the third pick, you get less than him. Don't nobody want to be the 49th fucking pick because you want the fucking Howard instead of going to one of these top programs because, okay, one thing for sure, two things for certain, him going to Howard, you know, that's good for Howard University, but it's a strike on him. You know why? Because now when the draft come up and they're going to be saying, oh, McCore Maker, oh, he averaged this and he averaged that, but he didn't play against elite competition and he didn't do, you know how it go, Tony. Come on, Tony.
You got a couple things, right? For starters, he's already good because his brother's a Steinmaker. He's already in the NBA. So his brother already set the path for the family. Steinmaker
was supposed to be better than what he is.
He is. I rock with the whole movement, though, because here's the reality. This kid right now is going to give other young black men the inspiration to go, you know what? Let me go take the leap of faith, too. Yes. What if the boy Mikey go with him to Howard? You think, ain't no, who the fuck you think? ESPN, everybody going to be, the camera's going to go follow the talent, bro.
Right.
I get you that you like, yo, I want my kid to go to the top school. The camera's going to follow the talent. And these people, like, these pros that's out here, I mean, scouts out here right now, they know who he is already.
So you saying he's not going to be in the top is. What? Right. What you saying? When you saying this decision is going to stop him from going what pick?
No, what I'm saying is when you get the most exposure, you're being seen. Him going to a team like Michigan State, Duke, Texas, Florida. All these teams got top athletes from all over the country. I'm not shitting on Howard University. I said if it was my fucking son. Because, okay, I go play at Michigan. I got five players out here that's all top athletes, man. I got five motherfuckers out here that probably got a chance to get drafted, go to the league, or go overseas and get some money. If I go to Howard University, every fucking game plan is going to be stop fucking him. If y'all going to beat us, the rest of these four motherfuckers going to do it because you ain't doing it, nigga.
That's what he probably get already.
It's difference in high school and college, Tony.
But you got to understand, Gil went to a bottom of the barrel white college.
That's cool.
Shout out to the
HBCUs,
you know why?
Man.
Shout out to him. I'm not shitting on the HBCUs.
He would have went to one of the, but they
you,
his game
y'all
wasn't
making it
enough.
Personal like I'm shitting on the HBCUs.
I'm not saying that.
I said it would be great for Howard University.
But is it great for the kid?
I said if that was my fucking son, mine. I'm talking a nigga out of going to Howard. No. You can go to Howard if no. you want to be a doctor? You want to be a lawyer? You want to do? Okay, go to Howard. Nigga, you want to go to the league? You want to get drafted in the top 10? You want to go somewhere? You want to go somewhere?
He not going to
fuck.
Top 10.
No, he ain't going in the top 10. I'm saying it now.
I'd like to take a wager on that. I want to take that one too.
Let me get that too.
Listen. And if he go in the top 10, imagine what he would have went if he was at.
No, but we got a bet though.
Is it a bet?
I'm saying if he goes in the top 10,
put me in there.
Imagine what he would have won if he would have got all the exposure.
What if he go top five?
He ain't going.
I'm
top
in there,
five.
Bet.
He ain't gonna get enough exposure to go.
He
top
gonna get
five
all the fucking exposure, bro.
Maybe 1,000 to 5,000, and he don't go number five.
Maybe dog. Let me ask you a question. When the fuck have you seen the Howard University game on
you
TV?
You about to see
it's
it?
Make
now.
The
they
bet.
Don't do it.
No. It's a bet. Make
one
it a
player
bet.
Gonna change the whole court. Now we gonna look up and see Howard University on ESPN, man.
Absolutely. If Mikey go to Howard too, it's over. Every game covered. Every game covered. If the boy Mikey go there, everybody coming.
Okay, let me ask you a question.
But who they gonna play?
No. Let me ask you a question, Tony. Do you realize that these colleges got TV contracts that's already in place? Tony, what the fuck are we talking about here, Tony? So now they just gonna fuck up the whole TV contract to throw Howard on, huh? Because one nigga went there.
So ESPN, you think ain't gonna cover this, the top 10?
Let me just say this. This nigga's not LeBron James. Okay? He's good, but he's not LeBron James. So, okay, so bam, they showing the highlights. Da 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 da. Oh, who's coming on first? Duke versus Texas. Ooh, oh, crowd. 26,000. Hey. And then you get to the second hour of SportsCenter. Let's go to Howard University. Footage all fuzzy and shit. You can't see the nigga.
Whoa.
Fuck out of here.
That's fucking racist.
I'm just saying. Let me ask you a question. You went to a black university, right?
Oh, that was
right.
Funny.
Let me ask you a question. When they be showing them the games that's not supposed to be on TV, do it be looking a little different from the Texas games and all that?
Absolutely.
I'm saying. I'm not shitting on the HBC. I'm telling the fucking truth. And if niggas don't like it, you know what you could do? You kiss my ass with your tongue out.
Oh, that was crazy.
Bitch, kiss my ass with your tongue out, bitch.
No, you was demanding. No, you didn't. No, you fuck you. I never invited nobody to my ass.
Did you say?
And I was in jail. You invite people. You just invited all these people to your
ass,
man.
Kiss my ass with your tongue out, bitch.
Fuck is wrong with y'all? So that's what I'm going to
do. You don't think the political, you don't think all the stuff going on with the Black Lives Matter is not going
to make the whole culture, everything.
Do you think that with the political climate that they're not going to rush to put that forefront, being that there's a reason why it hasn't been a forefront. There's a reason why HBCUs don't have the better television shit. And it's wrong.
Let me just ask you
this question. It's wrong, Gilly.
Let me just ask you this question. Deion Sanders' son.
Shout out to Deion.
He can go anywhere. Any fucking college he want to go to. You think if that nigga said, "Dad, I want to go to Grambling State," Deion said, "Nigga, what?" Wait, hold the fuck up.
What?
You talk about Grambling and don't get no fucking TV time? You talk about Grambling where ain't nobody gonna fucking see you, and you gonna have to throw for 11,000 yards a season to get fucking noticed? Oh, no. Fuck, you're not. The fuck, Tony wants the Winston-Salem University because that was the biggest fucking college that gave him a fucking deal.
Just like Capri was the only college he gave one.
No, it wasn't.
Howard and Lincoln looked fucking him over.
ICDC. I thought Gilly went to ICDC.
You wasn't that good.
You're a fucking hater.
He's mad because HBCU said he wasn't strong enough. That's all.
First of all,
you was a local neighbor. You was a fucking. You was a local neighborhood basketball fucking player.
I was a legend.
He went to a Catholic school.
He was a neighborhood basketball MVP. I was a legend. Fuck out of here.
Cool, but you was the captain of the wrestling team in prison. So,
at least I was captain.
He was this close to being an 87er.
Because you used to wrestle the shit out them niggas.
No, captain.
I was the coach, bitch. I said
I
the captain.
I was
the captain.
Team,
the captain is the best wrestler.
Like, no, don't fuck that. No.
Yeah. No, I was the captain. Yeah, I won all.
He was almost a sixer.
Shut the fuck up, Jamal.
Yo, you do that too good, dude. You do that too good. You be wrestling people, that's man.
Let's get into
Philly wrestling.
Let's get into our next sponsor, man.
So annoying.
Hey, legendary by Maker too, man.
That's legendary,
bro. Shout out to Maker, man. You're doing a great thing, man.
Shout out to you, baby boy.
Listen, shout out
to everything.
Let's have my fucking money. That's
Hey, facts.
Did you get my bet too? 47.60.
Your Apple Pay be a little slow too.
I said, Tom said, nigga, don't tell me about no Apple.
What about what's
name?
Toby beating the shit out of him, man. That's another story.
Hey, beating the shit out of him.
Let's get into our next
Simply
sponsor.
Safe.
Simply Safe. Listen, man. Simply Safe pretty much is the top of the line security system for the home. You know, I don't even got to really look at the paper because I know what Simply Safe is. I got it at my house. Simply Safe won best home security for 2020. Simply Safe is Simply Safe. It guards your home 24 hours. It monitors everything 24 hours. And the best thing about Simply Safe is 50 cent a day.
So it's 5 dimes.
Yes, 50 pennies, 2 quarters. 10 nickels, however the fuck you want to break it down, Goofy. All right. But it's 50 cents a day to protect your family. 50 cents a day to know, understand what's going on in the company of your own home. You feel what I'm saying?
Yes.
And it's simple to come in a box. You ain't got to have no people. Ain't got to come up to your house. They ain't got to come all in, be disturbing your household. No, no, no. Come right to you. Bam. Hook it up, bam, you're working. It's that easy. Press of a button, boop, oh, whole crib, cool, we good. See everything's going on, better not come up on my property. Oh, guess who's going to come if you come up on my property? The police, especially, that's Wallow's joint. He called the cops fast, so I'm going to get you out of here. What the fuck is that? It's a pigeon? I got a pigeon on my lawn, get him the fuck out of here. He get you out of here, you hear me? He done changed. You changed, cuz, I'm just saying, you changed.
He keep putting mustard on
my Officer Jonathan Tackle, you changed. But Simply Safe, man, is the wave for 2020, man. So anybody who need a home security, Simply Safe is where it's at, man. And if you go to simplysafe.com/game, you get free shipping, you get a 60-day money back guarantee. simplysafe.com/game to make sure they know that our show sent you, okay? Make sure they know our show sent you. So make sure you go to simplysafe.com/game. And listen, Game, don't be out here slipping, man. Motherfuckers break all up in your crib. You be mad as shit. You know what I mean?
They used to be a cat burglar.
They bringing white girl crib and steal 10 pairs of Air Force One. She be madder than a motherfucker.
10 pairs, she her boys.
Boy, don't she come in white girl crib.
Let me ask you this question, right? Is everybody that makes a racist slur to somebody, a racial slur to somebody, are they racist?
Well, black people can't be racist. Everybody knows that.
You know what I'm saying?
Break that down.
Okay, it's because let's just be for real. I'm guilty of saying a racial slur.
Not you.
To a person before. But I'm not racist. One time I was in traffic. White guy damn near ran me the fuck off the road. 100% his fault. I rolled him, what the fuck are you doing? This motherfucker started going off on me. Get the fuck out the way. We going back and forth out the window. I called him a cracker.
What type of cracker?
I called him every cracker in the book.
A Ritz?
A fucking Ritz saltine. Motherfucking peanut butter wet cracker. I called him anything. And he called me a nigger.
No, he didn't.
Yeah, we was nigger crackers.
No,
he didn't. We was a whole box of nigger crackers.
No, he didn't.
What I'm saying is, I'm not racist.
Was he racist, though? You think he racist?
I don't know. I don't, honestly, I don't even know if he was racist. I just feel like at that point in time, I was upset that this motherfucker would dare damn near run me off the road and then act like I did something wrong. He talking crazy to me. And at that time, I just wanted to say something to hurt a motherfucker feelings. It didn't have nothing to do with being racist or none of that. Only thing it had to do is I'm trying to come up with something that's gonna hurt this nigga's feelings.
Piss him off.
But this the whole
truth. Right? Like, I done got into situations with Asians and I done said some shit before.
Like
my
what?
Wife Asian.
Is she?
One of my best friends is Asian. That whole side of the family is Asian.
So you
I got white people in my family. My nieces and nephews are half white. My brother-in-law is white. That whole side of the family is white. I got white friends that I went to college with and played basketball with 24 years ago that we still kick it to this day. We might still get up, have lunch, go to brunch, go to a late early dinner or something. So
white people eat dinner early.
I'm not racist. They definitely do.
They definitely do.
I'm not racist at all. Sometimes you just be trying to say shit to hurt a motherfucker's feelings. Just like when you, it's just like in the household, me and two get to argue on one day. You feel what I'm saying? She said some shit to me. I said some shit back. It got heated. Now I'm trying to come up with anything to hurt her feelings. You feel what I'm saying? So I bust out. I called the fucking FSB.
What the fuck is it? FSB?
I said, fuck you fat shoulder bitch. What? Get the fuck out of here.
Fuck, they got to do with anything. She's skinny, Jerry.
Right. But at the end of the day, I was just trying to.
Fat shoulder, bitch.
I was just trying to.
She didn't let that fly, did she?
No, listen.
Two got fat shoulder?
No. I was just trying to come up with some shit to hurt her feelings. Like she said, fuck you, pussy. That's why you all balls and no stem. I was like, oh, all balls.
She blazed. That was true.
Like, the truth hurt. I know it wasn't the truth. I like
why I can't use a swipe.
I know it wasn't the truth. I know I ain't all balls. You feel what I'm saying? And no stem. She was trying to hurt my feelings.
Who would just randomly say that?
I'm just saying.
Nobody just pulls that out there.
Yeah, that was fuck you trying to say.
Yeah, that was true.
I'm saying
that
people say what they people say what they really feel when they mad, bro.
I'm saying that her shoulders are thick and your balls are bigger than your penis.
No.
I'm saying that y'all love each other.
Whole week went by. Whole week went by. And you came back to her. She like me.
How my shoulders?
Do you really think I got fat shoulders?
I'm like, that was cruel. You don't
I'm like,
do that.
I'm like, you got fucking fat too. Shut up.
That
like,
was so mean.
I was trying to hurt you. Right. That was the fucking purpose. You're trying to say something to fucking make that person hurt. So you're not going to say something nice. Shut the fuck up, you rice-eating bitch. Okay, I eat rice. So what? You're trying to hurt that person's feeling. You're trying to cut them deep at that point in time. So, do everybody that makes a racial slur to somebody?
The whole thing is about, see, if you say cracker, all right, cool. But the history of the word nigger is so vicious,
right,
that it got a different kick to it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, if you, especially if you say it to hurt somebody. Mm-hmm. Now, me and you talked about white people rapping rap lyrics.
Right.
Who buy the most rap records?
White people.
So if you're making a record and you saying this, you think, like we talked about it, people is going to emulate that record and they're going to talk about it. Right. They're going to rap the shit.
Right.
Right? Now, versus a motherfucker saying, nigger, that's a different spill. And you saying he used it to hurt you. Who said it first? Did you say cracker first or did he say nigger first?
I said cracker first.
Oh, so you set it off then?
I set it off because he was in the wrong and he was talking crazy.
Like he said, like what
I
said.
And at the end of the day, like I said, I was just trying to say something. Like the shit I was saying wasn't really getting through to him. Like, you know, I was like, bitch, you fucking ran me the fuck. Fuck you. Fuck out of here. What? You fucking cracker. You fucking cracker. You fucking.
Well, said, back okay, in the day.
You listen. Fucking nigga. Oh, all right, well,
but hold up.
He didn't come off like that at first. He might have been, okay, I'm cracking you a nigga then. Fuck it.
I like what Wallo said. Nigger is tied in blood. You don't know any stories where white people are randomly attacked by black people and it's like, oh, we killed these crackers. But you could tell a billion stories of black people murdered, okay, for no reason other than being black and being called a nigger. Well, so that's the difference. And I believe that we cannot be racist because we've been oppressed so long, so we're allowed to say that. And if you're a white person and you pull the nigger card, what's going on right now, you deserve that ass whooping you get on 95.
Oh, yeah, you're going to get fucked up. If you call somebody a white person saying nigger, you already
right now,
know. It's a 75% chance you're going to get your ass whipped.
All right,
okay, so let me ask you a question. So, if a person makes a racial slur towards somebody in a heated argument, heated conversation, they're racist, and that's what you're saying.
Right now, if you white and you drop an N-bomb, you're racist.
I'm not talking about white people. I'm not talking about black people. I'm not talking about Asian people. I'm talking about people in whole. If you having a heated argument with somebody and you make a racial slur towards them, are you racist? Because I'm not racist at all.
Only if you're white. That's my final answer.
Oh, well, we're going to go
to... What's your answer?
Oh, before I get my answer, there was a song one day by Sly and the Family Stone, and it goes a little something like this.
They white.
What? This is a classic by Sly and the Family Stone.
I know them. I didn't know that.
He said, "Don't call me nigga."
Yeah, that's the name of the song.
He's saying, "Don't call me whitey nigga. Don't call me nigga whitey."
Whitey. That was a song. Okay. It was a song. I used, you know.
Yeah, don't try it, Karen. Well, because I'm gonna whoop your ass.
At the end of the day, it depends. Everybody's situation. I know when I was in prison, and I mean, and I could go into story for myself. But when I was in prison, you had some vicious, vicious racist correctional officers. Prisons is in the middle of America. In the middle of small towns, and the only black people that's a part of that town is the ones that's in prison. Mm-hmm. Some of these people that never seen a black person in their life, and the only understanding they have of black culture is through entertainment and the stereotypes. So the way they operate, they're no joke. From the women, they not playing with you. You see what I'm saying? They not.
So what's the worst thing one of the COs told you?
No, it was this one CO. He used to always do. He was vicious. He used to always make the monkey noise. He used to do shit like that. And just be laughing all the time. Mm. He was vicious. And what
fuck that we putting him out there. Who was the CEO that violated and stuck the thumb in your ass that time when you was fuck that we fighting for your
ruin
rights.
Ruin the rule. What was
ain't
the man
nobody,
name?
Ain't nobody
what was
the man name?
What was his officer what?
Officer Ski.
What?
He was named Sergeant Ski.
Sergeant Ski. You fired next, bitch.
No. That's, a lot of them is poor. That's the last that's Sergeant the Ski. Last name. Oh, okay.
You next. You see all these people losing their fucking jobs.
What I'm saying is, it was racism on a whole nother level. They came in and their whole thing was about, listen, yeah, it was like a slavery joint to them. Like, that's how they carried it. Like, y'all niggas in slavery. We slave masters. So it was deep. That jail shit is deep. That's why a lot of people have a different perspective. And then when you get in there, you start getting knowledge and consciousness because you start reading about your history to understand what's going on in these fucking slave camps. And it just be like, the shit that I heard in there, man, it's just different.
Like what?
I'm talking about like shit like that. That's
like, well, say something.
The monkey shit, they'll call you a nigga. Like, that ain't no
flat to your face nigga.
Being a hole, you hear motherfucker going through the guard, nigga, shut up. You ain't gonna do nothing because you don't have nobody to look over them and what they do. Right. You're in their town, right? You're under their cameras, you're under their policy, you're under their rules, and it's just like.
Then you got whole generations that work there, the grandpa.
What? No. It'll be the whole family, nepotism. It'll be nepotism. It'll be the son, right? The dad, the grandpa, the uncle, the cousin, the wives, the whole family. Listen, you gotta understand, when prisons go to small towns in America, they build the whole economy. It'll be nothing there but grass. The next thing you know, and farms, next thing you know, Walmart coming to, because you gotta think about it. They got, first of all, give all these people these jobs in the prison, right? Then you got transportation, your family coming to visit, more people coming to this town now. They writing tickets. Everybody get pulled the fuck over when they go to see somebody in prison. So now they got that. The courts is like everything is like infuse everything. And at the same time, you'll build a community, but you'll tear your community down and then go up there. So it's deep as shit. But what I'm saying is though, they take care of their whole family and everybody be on some shit. So now I'm going through some shit with Sergeant so-and-so. Now, when I go down to medical, his daughter giving me a problem. Because you know me and him going, oh damn, when I go to work out in the gym, his nephew giving me a problem. Mm-hmm. So you got a battle, and then it's different cliques. So you got a battle against the Skis or the Kellys or whatever. It's 10 of them that work in the jail. So if you beefing one now, when it's time to go to commissary, the one that run commissary, we ain't get your bag missing. Because you gang one with a brother, that's your block sergeant. Mm-hmm. So that shit is a whole nother maze. Mm-hmm. It's like, nigga, you ain't getting around. Let's use a nigga. And so, you know, it's just deep. That jail shit is just like, it's just a whole nother story when we talk about rape. And just, you got to understand, you're getting it all the way through the court system and all this. So people got a right to feel the way they want to feel. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, you think about it, man. Just think about it. I got sentenced to 19 and a half to 52 years combined, 13 and a half to 27, and a 6 to 25. Think about that. Mm-hmm. I didn't shoot nobody. And I'm not saying what I did wasn't wrong. I had two armed robberies of establishments. I had two armed robberies and two firearms. How you get 19 and a half to 52 years? Bro? I didn't shoot nobody. I didn't touch nobody. But I understand. Hold up. I take accountability, and I understand when you pull a firearm out on somebody, it creates an unbelievable, I'm talking about memorable fear in them. And it get and I take full responsibility. But I know motherfuckers,
that shot motherfuckers and got 10 years.
Motherfuckers, you know what I mean? So it's like, no, I mean, I'm talking about like, so it's like, you just be like, is the justice system like, what do you do?
I just watched a judge's son get 6 months of house arrest for molesting a child and having child pornography in a small town of Pennsylvania. That's a fact. That's a fact.
Oh, let's get this
That's
right.
That's last week.
Let's get this right. The child molesters. The child molesters, they get the least time.
They don't do no time.
They get 3 years and shit.
Probation.
Touching
probation
kids and all that shit. So it's like,
this guy got 6 months of house arrest. Deep. He was facing 125 in. He's a judge's son. He got 6 months of house arrest and 3 years, and he has 15 years to register. He has 15. Nicki Minaj's husband got to register for the rest of his life. He has 15 years to register. That's it. For molesting a child and looking at child pornography.
A lot of times people don't have the complexion for the connection.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Gil.
Yeah, that's why we can't be racist.
Stories from the South.
Point done, I won. Next.
Let me ask y'all a question. If your girl, if you in a relationship, right, with a guy, your girl, an unfortunate situation comes up and they pass.
Damn.
But then you find out they was cheating.
Ain't that about a bitch?
What you doing?
How you doing? Put my ass at that funeral.
It's over with.
No. How you feeling?
How it's over? They dead.
It's dead.
I'm whooping ass at that funeral.
What I'm saying, how you feeling?
If the bitch walk in the funeral, I'm whooping her ass.
I ain't feeling no type of way. Just think about this, Tone. You tell me what you done. They dead.
Mm-hmm.
Like, what you going to do?
You're not going to be hurt.
No, I'm not petty like that. I know how to move on. At the end
when
of the day,
sex tape drop and she's sucking dick.
Oh, what you want me? What you?
I'm going to slap the dog shit out of Tootin'
the casket.
Right
in the casket. Boom!
Oh, you found out before the funeral, huh?
Yes, that's what we're saying. It all comes out, and then you got the funeral.
The other nigga sitting at the funeral, Ricky from Baltimore, at the funeral, he crying. He's
crying hard up the front.
You know that it's Ricky. It's Ricky.
He cried Ricky Blazer, the donut glazer.
Oh, Ricky Blazer.
And he
want
to sit up the front where you sit.
Yeah, he's sitting up the front.
In the special spot.
She had a whole relationship. Like, I'm talking about, she was in a real.
He in there crying.
He in there crying like a motherfucker.
You just sitting there looking at him like.
I'm going to turn to the old casket the fuck over.
I agree. I'ma help. I help you, Gilly.
I'm turning the bitch cast.
We getting put the fuck out.
I'm what? Red. No, they gonna pay the pick two dog look over.
They ain't gonna let me and Gilly come to the repass.
I'm getting. I ain't going to the repass. What?
And what you gonna scream when you be crying?
I can't believe it.
Fuck you, bitch.
Fuck
you dumb ass
shit.
Bitch.
Fuck you,
you gonna
bitch.
Say go to hell too, ain't you?
I'm like, what? That's why you going to hell.
Take her fucking jewelry off too.
Think of the worst type of nigga, man.
What?
You hold grudges in the grave.
The fact that the horrible part is this shit soon. Happens every
no,
day all over across America.
Part
the
is
bitches
this
meet
at the
funeral
crying.
How many times did the baby moms meet at the funeral?
Imagine that. He
all
a nigga
time.
At the funeral.
You
he really that. Hurt. Like he, this nigga act like.
And
he
what
more
proof
hurt.
You got? You got 100% proof.
Yes. He's there. No, he don't give a fuck about you. I'm coming to my bitch funeral.
Right. I don't care about Wallow.
Hey, bro, no! He ain't crying more than you. I don't know how I'm gonna make it.
What the fuck was she doing to him? She was sucking his soul out. She's a soul remover.
She sucked the leather off of Jackie.
You know they got a new shit called soul remover.
Soul
chicks out here removing people's souls.
What you gonna do, Wallo? You're not gonna say nothing to him?
What you gonna do?
No, but hold up. I seen that on the internet.
We already know what he gonna do. He gonna tackle Tony the Tackler. He gonna tackle the nigga.
He gonna tackle him. He didn't fight.
He in there meeking it. Damn, she was a thorough one.
Meeking there. Chases. Mika be like, oh, Melly, get him. What the fuck?
You ain't shit, nigga.
Melly, you don't let this nigga.
Y'all done?
No, we just fucked with
you. I'm just saying to him, but at the end of the day, no. Like, if a motherfucker in there crying, they had an encounter with a soul remover.
What is a soul remover? A soul remover.
Listen. I was listening. It's so no bullshit. Annoying. I was watching this porn tape, right? Well, video on X and XX. I just was breezing by and it popped. I don't know why. You watch porn? No, I just popped up. I was watching something on YouTube. And I think the ad came up. I don't know what happened. That never happens to me.
Ever.
It did on my phone.
Like,
but
that
that's
has absolutely never had. Porn saying, never that's... pops up while I'm watching YouTube.
No, well,
porn only pops up
alert.
While I'm watching porn.
Somebody must
porn
have signed me up,
up
for something in the email. So I don't know.
Whatever. No judgment.
But another side of the story is, and the dude was just laying on the couch, right? And he was getting, you know, fellatio and all that. And I don't know what happened, but on the screen, it was like his whole body came out of him.
Shut up.
You just seen it was like Ghost, the movie, and it was like, it was like, I'm leaving. I don't want to be here.
Yeah, they got some soul suckers.
He's a soul remover.
You just ain't removed a nigga's soul before. You don't know what the fuck we're talking about. You got the bad, you got to get your gag reflexes better. That's what them niggas in Delaware said. And they said, you don't activate your inner pigeon.
I'm not even responding.
I'm just telling you, they said,
get your fucking hands.
She only mess with dudes from New York. That wear butt naked Tim's. And
ain't
buy
no
Air Force
Delaware
ones.
Nigga talking about this pussy because I don't give out no pussy in Delaware.
Okay, so let me just say, let's show them your inner pigeon. Let's see your inner pigeon.
No, let me just say
this.
Get
the fuck out of here. You think I'm going to show. So, where out to my OnlyFans, you can see my pigeon.
She only mess with dudes from New York that buy Air Force Ones.
I know what is this next shit. I know how to suck a dick, Gilly.
Oh, you got some Cortez nights,
and
so?
You can't teach me how to suck no dick.
Well, I ain't trying to teach you how to suck.
You're trying to teach me how to suck a dick.
I taught Tootie how to suck and all. No, wait.
She got some Cortez nights.
He talked my pussy trash on Instagram last week. He got one more. I'm going to bust his ass on this podcast.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, you
said
the pussy
is amazing. Yeah, he said the pussy. She put a little trash.
No, she was putting
pussy.
You said the pussy was trash.
He put the pussy
I never
trash
said your pussy
all
was
I
trash.
I said was a nigga never bought me a Chanel bag. That don't mean the pussy trash.
Okay, hold on. If we say, how do a woman determine whether she a nigga supposed to buy her bags and shit? You said good pussy. I said,
we can solve all this.
I said, hold on. I said, a nigga bought you a Chanel bag? You said, no. Your pussy trash.
Listen, we can solve this. I have a lot of fans out there. If you want to buy me Chanel bag, just shut him the
fuck
up.
Get Tony some pussy. We Tony going to tell us.
They already think I'm trying to fuck Tony. Tony was my MCM last week. They already think I'm trying to fuck.
Tony said he'll bake the shit out you in the back of the Lambo. You hear me?
Damn, why black car pussy killing?
Yes, that's
you
the
just
best.
Think the lowest of the
no,
low?
That's
I
the
give them
best.
No pussy in the Lambo,
first of all,
bro.
First of all, the best, some of the best pussy is car pussy.
Really?
Because you gotta, because it's
comfortable,
the,
too
no,
small.
It's the whole, you gotta make sure. Oh, some people yeah, walking
let
by.
Let me find out you and Tootie parked at the Target fucking
no,
in the parking lot.
No, me and Tootie parked down at the Piazza. What's that on, right there in Girard? That's, what's that called? Right there, second and Gerard and all that. What's that called?
The Piazza. Yeah,
that's the Piazza?
Yeah,
this shit way before
Tootie. Tootie ass up at the Piazza.
This shit, no. He been
ew
on the car tip. You remember yeah you used to fuck the
that's exciting.
In the car.
The fuck out of here.
I'm not fucking a nigga in the back of
the
Lambo. You can fuck your husband
right next
in the car, but you're not
on the
fucking
sidewalk,
the person.
In the Pontiac
the fuck out of here.
And I used to stim.
Hey, what's the top five hip-hop labels?
Oh, that's easy.
Ever?
That's easy.
Death Row.
Oh, this shit hard.
Bad Boy.
Death Row.
Def Jam. No Limit.
Damn, you
Cash
got
Money
you
done.
Got, you got rock, you got a lot of big joints. You got is you talking about independent like you're not talking about like the Def Jam.
Just
no,
name
no, no,
them.
No. Oh, Def Jam. Oh, Def
no,
Jam.
No. The top five record labels built by, you know, independent people like coming in the game. Like
Def Jam was independent.
Yeah, so Def Jam, absolutely.
You say Def Jam, you say like
Cash Fucking Money.
Is you talking about just labels, or do they got to be?
This nigga always got to dissect shit.
They joint ventures with the big labels.
All right, well, Loud Records had Mobb Deep, Wu-Tang Clan, and a bunch of people. Loud Records, Steve. You got motherfucking Cash Money. The label you got kicked off because you was a bum ass, fake ass rapper that wasn't on that level. That was too big. That was too big of a level for you to be on. You wasn't on the That's label. Cool. You was no Z Lee rap. You wasn't supposed to be near.
We know if you would have ever got signed to Cash Money, you'd have still been over there.
Fucking right, I'd have been
know,
over there.
No, because you'd have been baby fucking ad libs.
No, no, I wouldn't. That'd
have been. Did his verse say, "Come do my ad libs"? Well, you'd have been all in the booth.
I wouldn't. I wouldn't. How much you want to bet? You know what I would have did? You know what I would have did? I'd have been right there. I did mine better than that. I wouldn't have fucked this
record up. You'd have been gold. I made sure
you'd have been baby jewelry holder.
So listen. So you got Def Jam.
Get my chain out of there.
Well, first of all, you got Def Row. Def Row killed it. You got Ruthless Records. You got, I'm going to just name a couple.
Ruthless,
and we're going to pick. You got Swab House.
Fucking Ruthless.
You got Swab House. You got Rap-A-Lot. You got Cash Money. You got
No Limit,
God
damn it.
You got QC and them doing their fucking thing now. You got
No
I say,
limit.
I say No Limit. I always say P.
Okay.
Okay. So.
Master P is without no doubt.
We throw Cash Money in there. They sold a lot of fucking records.
For sure.
But let's put it in order.
Okay. Number one would have to be
Def Jam.
Def Jam.
It gotta be Def Jam.
Def Jam's number one. Def Jam started that shit.
Mm-hmm. All right. Go ahead. Who else?
Number two would have to be Cash Money.
All right, now sidebar. Now sidebar. You know you got Rockefeller.
You gotta understand, Cash Money had a whole fucking run with just the Cash Money artists.
But they did it right after P did it first.
No. You gotta understand. At one time, Juvenile was the biggest artist in the game.
For sure.
Nigga sold 4 million records.
For sure. I'm a big Juvie fan.
Okay, cool. Then they had Wayne. They had Turk. They had
Gilly.
They had
No. He never got mentioned on the roster line.
They had Big Timers. Then
they had Mac 10.
They ran it up to 300 million or whatever.
So?
And then they came back
with the Young Money shit.
With the Young Money shit. Yeah. With the Young Money shit was really Cash Money. So
okay.
They got the Drake. They got the Nickies. They got the
Mac Main,
the Mac Mains, and the all them.
You know the same mention himself.
I'm a staple of building Cash Money
for sure.
Fuck nigga,
it was built when it came.
For sure,
fuck wrong with you.
It was at a
fucked up time when I got around there.
You ain't do nothing down there.
Fuck is wrong with you?
Talking about?
That's when Flow Chain. You remember?
So Def Jam, Cash Money.
Now remember, I'm just saying, I'm just throwing them out there. You got Murder, Inc., Rough Riders. We had a lot of fucking labels. I'm just saying, we got to acknowledge everybody.
Damn, Murder, Inc. Remember what 50 did to them? Yikes.
Gotta put Murder, Inc.
Murder, Inc. was fire.
You have to put Murder, Inc. in there.
G-Unit as a label?
You gotta put Murder, Inc. in there because of
Ashanti.
Ashanti. Mm-hmm. Ja Rule.
Was a huge star, Ashanti was.
And they had somebody else.
And Ashanti still look good. Shout out to Ashanti. Your body is crazy.
Lloyd. Did they have Lloyd?
Ashanti, Ja Rule. No.
Don't forget Jermaine. We not going to forget Jermaine. So Def.
Rough Riders.
Huge Rough Riders fan.
First of all, you got to say Def Row Master P. You got to say Def Row Master P.
Master P. Okay, so that's four right there.
Rough Riders.
And what's the fifth?
Rough Riders.
That's hard. You got Rockefeller.
Okay, once again, it's The Rock.
Mm-hmm.
The Rock!
You got to put that in there. You got to put a Rock in there.
Rockefeller artists never really sold no records like that, man.
Kanye. Jay-Z.
That's it.
Cameron. Beans.
No. Cameron and Beans.
Well, your Cam came
Cam
over
Cam
there.
Was came over there.
He came
Beans.
Over. Beans always went gold, right?
Kanye, Jay, you can throw the Rock in there.
So you saying that's the five? We can't get the five. That's a great, because it's too many fucking labels. You got you got Jay Prince, you got Rap-A-Lot. Right. They did a lot. You got Tony Draper, he did. I'm talking about people, and there was a lot of people like Tony Draper that was behind the scenes that helped a lot of these big labels that y'all fucking hear about.
Well, absolutely.
You know what I mean? But Master P is just like, so that's going to be, I don't even know, that'd be hard to come up with five.
It is, but shout out to all of them because they doing their thing, man. Hey, let's get into stories from the cell, man.
Stories from the cell. Listen, one thing about this is this. I remember when I called Gil one time, right? And this nut ass nigga, he was too Hollywood. This is a story from the cell. And I felt some type of way, and I like checked him. I called him. So he had a thing of giving bump money for me to send to me. And I said, yo, man, what the fuck's going on, man? He told me, yeah, I gave it the bump. I said, yo, I ain't get that bread. So he say, oh, I gave it the bump. This time I said, you gave it the bump. I said some shit like, yo, what the fuck you keep, like, what the fuck you keep getting my money to somebody else? Like, you too good to fill out a money order and all this dumb. No, nigga, I'm out here doing shit. I said, you nut ass nigga. Like, I'm on the phone. He laughed. I said, so this is when the story from the cell is about a nigga that got a family member on the street that went Hollywood. And this nigga thought he was a bitch. And so he said, I'm doing shit. He gonna tell me, did you just see me on MTV? I said, you nut ass nigga. They got
you
pop.
Said
they
that?
Got, they got nut ass motherfuckers. Yes, he did. I said, they got anybody could be on that. MTV, real life, true life. I said, MTV. I said, you nut ass nigga. I'm in the phone room. Like, you nut ass nigga. He tell me, man, I'm out here. I'm moving.
Tell him what I told you, nigga. Ask Ricky Minaj for some commissary, nigga. Fuck
you
didn't know
about Ricky.
You. Yes,
somebody told you about fucking Ricky since I've been home.
I said, that's why I stopped sending money because I heard you was up there walking the track with Ricky.
He fucking lying. So but this fake ass with Ricky. Listen, so a lot of times
a nigga
I understand when niggas had neighborhood hits and they start feeling themselves.
They said
they get a little record money.
They say he's up there walking the track.
He was a nut ass nigga too.
This is crazy.
He was a nut ass rapper nigga too that he thought he gonna tell me on the phone. I'm in prison, real live nigga. I'm standing there in prison like this. What?
Mm-hmm.
I said what? I said nigga, you lucky I can't jump through this phone. He gonna tell me. Oh man, I'm doing big shit
I'm busy,
out here.
Busy nigga. I'm fuck, I around. Gave it to a nigga. He gonna send it to you, man.
Got my motherfucking commissary. Shit,
gave
my money
bump.
On hold.
Shout out the bump.
Gave it the bump.
I said nigga, I gave it to you. I gave it to a nigga, man. He gonna.
Yeah. I think bump was flipping my money too,
he
man.
He probably was, man. Nut ass nigga, man. Nut ass nigga taking flipped it. That little bean 200. Yeah, I mean that's what it was. That's why you was really
no. One time it was a little higher than that. That's how I knew when you was getting fucked up out here. I'm like, damn, hold this joint was a little lighter, and she got lighter. That nigga, this rap. That nigga really Wayne. On his ass out here because it seemed like as soon as he went through the shit with Wayne, money order started getting goofy. Started coming up, ain't answering my calls.
$20 now.
I'm telling you, no, them Jones got real low. And I'm like, damn, where the $500-$600 at?
The fuck I said, you $8?
No, you sent me some bullshit. I'm like, where the $500-$600 at now? Well, Wayne on his ass, he ducking and dodging money. He on the run money. I'm like, you sent a little $100. I said, what the fuck I'm gonna do with $100, nigga? I mean,
eat, nigga. That's a whole month worth of food.
But I just was fucked up. And I went back to myself. I'm like, yo, this nigga is
plenty of mackerel.
That ass nigga's a Hollywood rapper now. He thought he was
a fucking nut putting that smut on my name.
Nah, it was real though. You told me.
I told you, nigga, I'm busy.
I'm out here popping. I'm doing shit.
What's wrong with you, man?
You popping?
I told you, nigga. I told you, nigga.
You just see me on MTV?
I said, nigga, go get something from fucking Ricky Box real quick.
No, you ain't
tell
me
that. Money come through, man.
Ricky did have a hell of a box. I ain't never.
What?
I'm just saying, no. He did have a hell of a time.
You had to been a Ricky Minaj cell to know that. You had to,
I
seen him come around.
Stop playing.
I seen people
like
drop
this. He's
off.
Playing now.
Hey, listen, man, before we get out of here, man, we want to give a shout out to RonaProof.com, man. Each and every week on Sunday,
a friend
3
of the pod,
p.m.
Man.
Yeah, I mean,
Tony, MC
Tony the closer.
Tony the tackler.
Tony the tackler is teaching y'all how to get this money, man, without no money.
Tony
man.
The tricker.
And Tony, I do want to commend you, man.
See. You just want him to trick on you.
That's what it is.
Oh, she ain't saying shit.
White girl, I'll fuck your whole life up. Don't play with me.
Right. Oh! Do we see a date? Do we see
what?
$1 million over game, make a date? Go on a date tonight. Go ahead, y'all.
I like nice guys. That's not
Tony said he nasty. You put a finger in your butt and then in your mouth.
Damn.
Sugar daddy, baby. I love sugar daddies, Tony.
A finger in your butt, then in your mouth. Sound like a Friday night.
Oh, that! Whoa, she into that.
Oh,
Friday night. Air Force Ones. You
she
wake up.
Such an old
she
let
them shitty thumbs. Listen like that. Thumb
you wake up, Air Force Ones on the counter. Fresh
I think
beer.
Everybody like box. A little thumb in the butt, right?
No, whoa.
You don't like a little thumb in the butt?
Gil ain't say Gil ain't say Gil ain't
fighting.
What
are you talking about? I thought she was talking about women.
Hey, real talk though. Hey, on the Rona proof, a lot of people hit me up because they thinking that they got to have like a license or they need to have their credit to get started. You do not need credit, no license to get started. It's literally 10 steps. I'm going to show you on a free training. Every Sunday, 3 o'clock, you can tune
every
in.
Every Sunday, 3 o'clock, RonaProof.com.
Literally, no money, no credit needed. You can get started. We get going real quick.
And you show them how to, you got my cousin some money. And since you came on the first show, my cousin and my pop, been on your shit, and they in the process of getting that bag. So, you know,
the bag.
Congratulations, sure. Man. Jump you're doing on your it, thing, y'all. Man. And I see you get a lot of hate out here. Niggas hating on you now, huh?
That's part of it, man. I got on the biggest podcast in the game right now.
That's a part of.
So right now we having real estate wars.
Tony, hey, what's going on?
Hey, man.
Well, they on his top all on the internet.
Yeah.
One guy said, and Tony. Oh, we're not even going to talk about Tony.
That's Tony amazing. The closer.
The closer.
Because his name Tony the Tackler.
Hey, man.
Tony
listen,
the Tackler.
Hey, one thing about it, man, I realized, and Wallo put me on his track. He said, let your haters be a marketing team. Mm-hmm.
Haters, you know what I mean? Your marketing team.
Like, it's just been part of it. Like, I got on the podcast, and everybody obviously sees, like, your shit got reach. And it just, you know, the hate, it come with it. And I love it because at first it pissed me off because obviously you see people putting smut on you like you know, y'all can play with that shit. But
you
I know, be,
like he put fucking smut on me, you can say it.
No, I never put that. Like, the stuff but, about you telling, that was real. I just don't talk about it.
Oh, it is real.
Yeah, it is real. He's a rapper.
Oh, damn. But for real though, man, we got like a huge opportunity for a lot of people to be able to move forward in the culture. And I think like right now we got to really support each other. And that's what I'm about. So I really don't try to put that. I try not to hype it up too much, but it's a thing. The hate come, you know, it come with the game. You know what I'm saying? Niggas like, oh, Meek fucked your bitch, and then everybody know my name after that, right? Mm-hmm. And after that, it becomes, you know, where any and everybody that want attention, they try to use your name.
Oh, yeah, they definitely do. Yeah. Ignore them.
Fuck them.
Yeah, fuck them. Yeah. But let's get up out of here, man.
Get fucked every day. Don't worry about
it. It's cool, Tony. It's cool. Man, yeah, Blaze. She blazed it. Meek blazed your bitch. It's cool. Bitch, you still listen to his music. Right. Other side of America.
Hey, everybody cool. Bitches get fucked out of here, nigga. Yeah. I done fuck a lot of niggas' bitches, so hey, it's part of the game.
After that, right? Meek turned into somebody else. Fucking anybody bitch now.
Tony running around here just trying to blaze niggas' bitch.
Trying to blaze shit.
Hey, listen, man, we appreciate y'all for tapping in each and every week, making us the number one music podcast in the country each and every week. Let me tell you something. Go to barstoolsports.com, pick your merch up, get your $1 million worth of game merch. When your merch come, make sure you do a video and send it to us, man, because we like to post, man. We like to show love back to the motherfuckers that support us. So get your $1 million worth of game merch. Holler at my son at 37 Matt. Get your mac and cheese merch, but make sure you go to Barstool Sports and pick up that
and make sure you get that
merch.
Book, that new book I got out.
New book.
Right now, listen, check out the new book, The Mind of Wallo 267. Check it out, man. You know, cop up, man.
Check it out, man. And Lincoln, listen, man, each and every week, appreciate the love. I go by the name of Gilly the King.
I'm Wallo 267.
Don't call me white girl.
Tony the Closer.
Tony the Tackler.
The Tackler. And the Queen of the Mile. The Queen of the Mile. And it's just like that.
Right!